One of the reasons why many people enjoy fishing isn't so much the catch as it is the privacy. Is there any better way to spend time outdoors than by enjoying the peace and quiet while focusing on a relaxing activity? That's certainly what Brad Mack, a Pennsylvania fisherman, was thinking when he recently decided to take a fishing trip in Raystown Lake. Yet his view on the matter changed since that fateful day. His chosen fishing spot was so secluded that Brad couldn't even get a signal on his cell phone. So when trouble showed up, he was forced to make a difficult and possibly dangerous decision that would change how he felt about fishing forever. On May 21st, 2017, fisherman Brad Mack from the small town of Everett, Pennsylvania, took a trip to Huntington County's Raystown Lake. Brad settled into a spot at James Creek, not expecting anything out of the ordinary to happen on his fishing expedition. Something strange did happen, though, but it had absolutely nothing to do with anything that Brad caught on his line. It all started when he saw some sort of movement in the lake. Initially, he thought it was just a floating log. Raystown Lake is a heavily wooded area, so it wasn't too far-fetched to think that the object in question was anything else. When he got a closer look, though, it seemed to start like the log was covered in fur. I saw it coming in towards me. I thought it was just a beaver or something like that, Brad said in an interview. When the object floated closer to him, though, he realized it was nothing of the sort. It got closer, and I looked at it and I thought, holy crap, recalled Brad, as he suspected it was a wild animal after all, only it still was not one that he thought he would see so far on the lake. Finally, close enough to the truth, Brad realized the piece of flotsam was actually a brown bear cub struggling to tread water. The poor creature was so exhausted that he was just barely able to keep his snout above the water. The little cub actually seemed to be trying to swim towards Brad's boat, as if he knew that the man was his only chance at finding help. The fisherman knew that he had to do everything in his power to save the suffering creature. Brad knew then what he had to do, though it was difficult to convince himself to pick up the cub with his bare hands. Even mere seconds before he actually went through with it, he was questioning himself. Would the bear try to bite him? Would his mother attack from somewhere nearby? Still, he had no time to waste. Just as I was ready to grab it, I thought to myself, please don't bite me, remembered Brad. Luckily, the grateful cub didn't seem to have any intention of harming his savior in any way. It was as calm as can be. It didn't show any hostility towards me, said Brad. Nobody could have blamed him if he had admitted to being more than a little nervous about the incident, though. Brad had to be careful about his next move, though. What on earth was he supposed to do with a bear cub on his boat? There was no cell phone reception in the middle of the lake, so he couldn't contact an expert. He did have one idea, though. I saw the direction it was swimming in, said Brad. He decided that the cub had probably lost his mother and was still looking for her, so he turned the boat in that direction. I kind of figured that maybe the mom swam across first, said Brad about his plan, and because the baby was so little, it was struggling. I just figured that she'd be up on the bank somewhere. Once Brad made it to the opposite side of the lake, he gently placed the bear cub on land. The little creature, cold and frightened, scampered off, but not before taking one last look at Brad. It was as if he was thanking the man for his help. Despite the fact that Brad's heroic actions undoubtedly saved the cub's life, the Pennsylvania Game Commission strongly advises against anyone doing a similar thing. Touching wild animals can be extremely dangerous, and they advised against it. It should be noted that despite how gentle the cub was, Brad put himself in an incredibly dangerous position. If the cub's mother had seen Brad with her baby, the man could have been in serious trouble. Brown bears are known to viciously attack humans when they feel as if their cubs are threatened. Authorities are also concerned about bear urbanization. Brown bears generally prefer to stay in their natural habitats in the wild. If they become too comfortable in human-dominated environments, however, that could change. The Pennsylvania Game Commission made it clear that anyone who found themselves in a similar position as Brad should call them for assistance. Of course, Brad had no way of doing that without cell phone reception, so he had to make a gut decision. The cub was going to drown if I didn't help it, he said. I never thought anything else other than to get it help and to take it to shore. He also hoped that the bear cub found his mom. Hopefully, they can get reunited again, he added. While Brad's actions may not have been well advised, his quick thinking seemed to have worked out for the best. Hopefully, that bear cub found his mother after all.